guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to a slightly different setup. As you probably know, we are now in our new home, so I'm settling in to this new office area, which I will give you a tour of soon. It's currently still a little bit of a mess, but once it's done, I will show you, hopefully in the new year. But we are settling in so nicely, and thank you so much for all of your kind messages throughout the move. It was a little bit challenging, but I'm glad I can now breathe a little bit better and just settle into our new home. And if you don't already know, we are actually doing a bit of a renovation to, well, quite a big renovation to this house to get it the way that we want it. So if you want to follow along on that journey, then head across to my lifestyle channel, which is Sarah Jane Fregola. I'll leave a link in the description box below. But yeah, I'm so excited to share this with you and share this new space once it's done, so keep a lookout for that. I actually cannot believe that it's nearly the end of the year. It's crazy. This is my November chit chat video, so the last one before the end of the year. And I thought I'd do a little bit of something different this time and do a gift guide, a crochet gift guide. I did this a few years ago and it went down really well. So if you're looking for inspiration on gifts to ask for, which are related to crochet, or you're looking for ideas of presents to gift for a fellow crochet lover, then stick around because I have some ideas for you. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to start off with a few books. There has been some amazing book releases this year. And there's one also in this suggested list, which is a little bit older as well. But it's just so amazing. You've probably seen these on my channel already in some of my chit chat videos. But these books are so cool and I thought that I'd share them with you. They're more kind of project books rather than beginner's books, but some really, really gorgeous projects in these books. So let's get started. This is the first one that I recommend. This is Crochet Cafe by Lauren Espy. This is a book filled of amigurumi crochet patterns and it is the most adorable book you have ever seen. So as the name suggests, Crochet Cafe, there's all like food and drink projects, which is just so cool. And I really love the way that this is laid out as well, almost like it's a menu. So here, look, it's like it's a menu, Eggs Benedict. It's just super, super cute. Sorry, quick battery change there. And I was about to say that I love these strawberries, but then I realized that they weren't strawberries, they are actually tomatoes, cherry tomatoes. But yeah, I really love this one. It's really cute. And if you are into your amigurumi, then definitely give this a go. Crochet Cafe by Lauren Espy. I will leave links in the description box below of where you can get your hands on these. Next up is a book that I've had for a while. Again, this was sent to me. And I just thought this is a really nice book if you want to start thinking about spring projects, which some people do just before Christmas, because some people are a season ahead. I'm definitely not. But that's this book, The Spring Collection by Wendy Van Delden. There is just some really gorgeous projects in here. So if you're looking for like garments and cushions and just really cute crochet, then this book is definitely for you. So in here it says 20 crochet patterns of cardigans, blankets, pillows, scarves, shawls and baskets. It's just really cute. So again, I'll leave a link in the description box to that. We then have this one, and this is by Teresa from DeBros. This is Modern Crochet, so really minimalist kind of patterns, but they are absolutely beautiful. I love the way that she has a very monochrome style to her projects. They're really simple, but absolutely stunning. Forget how many projects are in here. 16 original patterns. And then also there's like charts and different things like that. So if you or somebody you know is a bit more modern or minimal, then this is definitely the book for you. And then finally, we have the gorgeous Jessica from The Hook Nook. Making with Meaning, more than 20 meditative and creative crochet projects. Jessica is just so lovely, so supportive. I absolutely adore her and I adore her style as well. She makes some really nice modern makes and there are some gorgeous projects in here too. And it's also a really nice read as well. There's sections in here where you can read through, and it's just absolutely gorgeous. I was sent this one, but I also pre-ordered one of my own, so I have an extra copy of this. Can we see where this is going? I'm going to give away one of these copies, so all you have to do is head to my blog. I'll leave a link in the description box below, and I'll set up all of the information on there of how to enter. So yeah, this one is absolutely gorgeous as well. Jessica also has her own products as well. So she has yarn, she has hooks, she has all sorts of things. So make sure that you go and check her out. Next up, I want to talk about subscriptions. So subscriptions are a really nice gift, actually, whether you ask for them or you're given them, because I think it's just something that you can get continuously throughout the year and get a huge amount of pleasure from them. So the first subscription I want to talk about is a magazine subscription. So this is Crochet Now magazine, my favourite crochet magazine, and I'm not just saying that because I have a monthly column in it. I genuinely do love this magazine. I think it's full of amazing projects, and I do think that there is something in there for everyone each and every month. It's jam-packed full of some amazing designers. So if you're on the hunt to follow or find some new designers to follow, then definitely check it out and go and find them on Instagram and on their blogs and things. But look at this. How gorgeous is that? So this is the Frosty Flowers wreath, and this is by, oh, Heather C. Gibbs. I love Heather. She's amazing. So yeah, just some absolutely adorable things. There was some gorgeous baubles in there as well, and that they are by the Rico design team. Just absolutely stunning. So I think it's a really nice mix of projects in here. And as I say, I also do a monthly column where I do a bit of a stitch tutorial. Let me see if I can find it. So here we go. This is the one here. So it's called Crochet Chronicles. This is issue 62, if you're interested. So yeah, you can get a subscription for this. And I think that's a really lovely thing to have. So whether you ask for it or if you purchase it for somebody, Crochet Now magazine is a winner from me. And then of course we have the Crochet Society subscription box. So this is my subscription box. I know, might be biased, but I love it. This is box 19, which subscriptions are currently open for, and this will be going out beginning of next year. So if you've not heard of Crochet Society, it's a monthly crochet subscription. Inside you'll get some gorgeous yarn, quite often it's exclusive yarn as well, which makes it even more special. You'll get at least 3 crochet projects which you can choose from in order to make. Lots of people, when they're doing this, they actually make at least 2 or 1 large project and maybe 2 smaller. It depends what the projects are each month, but then they might actually use a yarn substitute and make the other ones. You also get some crochet goodies in there and a mini magazine with all of the information. I also do crochet tutorials to go alongside these, which are exclusive to subscribers. So if you're a bit iffy with patterns, then you can go ahead and watch those. So many people have said that they've actually learnt to read patterns since they've had this subscription box. Each and every month, it's a complete surprise of what's in there. So it makes it so exciting to wait for this being delivered to your door. Now you can have a 3-month subscription, 6-month or 12-month. So that's the benefit if you want to ask for a smaller or larger subscription. Or if you just wanted to go ahead and sign yourself up, you can just sign up on a monthly basis if you prefer. But the longer you sign up for, the better discounts you get. So just bear that in mind. All of the information is on the website, crochetsociety.co.uk. There's also tabs depending on what country you are in to tell you what the price will be. Obviously, because shipping will be slightly different per country, but the price you see on the website is the price you pay, so there's no hidden extra costs or anything like that. So I think this is an amazing gift to receive and to give. So if you're looking for a box full of crochet goodies to be delivered to you or your friends or your family members, then go ahead and check this out. Okay, so now I want to talk a little bit about yarn, and I have absolutely been loving indie yarns, hand-dyed yarns, and I have a few here to show you. You might have seen them in past videos. I will be completely honest, I'm a little bit obsessed with buying them, and then I just think they're far too pretty, and I get a bit overwhelmed, and then end up not making much with them. So there are some here which I haven't yet used, although I have used one. I'll show you in a moment. But I just thought I'd share them. So the first one is from In the Crochet Corner. This was bought via Etsy, I believe. So let me just take this out here. So In the Crochet Corner, this color is absolutely stunning. So let me just read it. It's called Lulu. It's fingering sock weight. It's 75% merino, 25% nylon, and then I have two 100-gram hanks. So how stunning is that? Absolutely stunning. I would love to make some socks. It's been on my to-do list for such a long time, but unfortunately, other things keep taking priority. So dare I say I would like to knit some socks. Sorry guys. But yeah, I love this. Absolutely gorgeous. Those colours are just stunning. So that was In the Crochet Corner. I will leave a link in the description box below. We then have these. These are from Woolly Mama Yarns. She has a website and an Etsy. I think I got these through Etsy. This one is called Mid Summer. Again, absolutely gorgeous. I really kind of love these brighter colours in these indie dyed yarns. And then San Junipero. Junipero. San Junipero. I hope I've pronounced that right. How gorgeous are these? So again, I just see them and I just think they're so gorgeous that I just never know what to make with them. However, this next one, so this is Handmade Home Fibres. So this is by Sorella. I'm sure you've heard of her before. I got two of the same colour and I actually combined it with Stylecraft Special DK, I think it was. And I made the Jagged Little Wrap, which is by Sam from Little Bud Creations. I always get confused whether it's Little Bud Creations or Little Bud Designs. I'll leave it in the description box below. I always want to say one and it's actually wrong, it's the other one. But yeah, I made this with that yarn and it just came out so well. I absolutely love it. So I now have another one which I don't know what to do with. So yeah, if you don't often indulge in hand-dyed yarns because they do tend to be a bit more expensive, then maybe ask for some for Christmas because it's good to have a play around with things. And when it's a gift, it's even better, isn't it? So there we go. There are my suggestions for Crochet Christmas gift guide. I really hope that you have enjoyed it and enjoyed my suggestions. If you have any other ideas, then please leave a comment in the comment section below. Because people might be looking for more ideas. But don't forget, I'll leave all of the links in the description box below. But thank you so much for watching. I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up, leave me a comment, and also share with your friends. Maybe even share this video with your significant other or your family and friends so they can have ideas of what to get you for Christmas. Also, don't forget to subscribe to keep up to date with all of my latest videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I shall see you again next time. Bye. The bin men have just come to collect the bins and they can see me filming. Awkward.